Agriculture, State Department of Livestock and Fisheries. But today here I'm here on matters livestock in Bomet, and we are here to talk about milk, and specifically the Mursik, which the people around this region are well known for. Our runners, you know, they have also promoted that Mursik. That's the Mursik I'm talking about, which you normally see them drinking in Aguad, fermented milk. That is really what I would say has been the heritage of the Kalenjin ethnic group in Kenya. However, times have changed, population have increased, yet in every meal we want to have Mursik. When we have functions, ceremonies, we must have Mursik. Now, we would want them to make in a hygienic way, because of late we've heard of incidences, which I'm sure the fourth estate like yourself must have come across, of maybe handling of milk, and that is why we have the Kenya Dairy Board here with us. Actually, I'm here with Kenya Dairy Board because of the issues of quality of milk. And so we're here to promote the hygienic way of making the traditional Mursik or Mala for the people around this region, knowing that we are soon going to have seasons of Shere Shere. And with us is one supplier of the cultures and enzymes that are used to make Mala in a modern way. This is what we want to introduce. The traditional way of making Mursik, you will discover in our training today, and I welcome you to see, is that we lose some very important part of the milk, thinking it is water, but yet it is the protein part of the milk. So the process we are going to train people on today is how to make the whole milk hygienically, safe for consumption, and within a short time than the traditional one, which takes time, so that we can have it available. We really look, as Minister of Agriculture through the Kenya Dairy Board, looking at the quality. We hope that then this Mursik can actually be available for all of us, even on the shelves of the supermarket. And so in the process, we shall be adding value to the milk. We shall be holding, the shelf life will be increased. And that's why we're here today, to train various people. We train TOTs especially, those who make the traditional Mursik, that they can be able to do so. And we are glad that the reception by the county government of Bomet has been good. Last month we were here on issues of AI, and today now we are here to address the issues of milk. Quality Mursik, healthy, hygienic, and you can get it just like the way you would get Mursik, you would get Mala in the shop. So that is what brings me over here. And another issue I am running with this, and I'm asking the Kalenjin community and the pastoralist communities, where we find that they have a lot of milk, they take milk as a meal. Let us look at the hygienic process, the handling of our milk. And you can see this is something that we traditionally do. So when you see me say, let us leave the other part of our tradition, which is not good, it does, yes, I'm not out of order. The other traditions which are harmful, like FGM, is what I say, forget about that one, but let us run with this good one of making milk, and we can actually see it being an international product. Because after all, you see, when they land at the airport, they take that Mursik. Now we want to go a notch higher by ensuring the safety of this Mursik is even good with somebody who has just been eating. Maybe this, who has not been hardened by the environment they are in.